Seas battered our east coast last night, and nowhere more than in Newcastle, County Down, where gardens were washed away and sea walls crumbled. BBC Newsline's Rosie Billingham joins us live from the weather-beaten town. Rosie, what's the latest?
Well, here in Newcastle, last night saw two boats sink and water pour through homes. Everyone knew the wind and waves were coming. And so today, a lot of people have been asking why it took the authorities so long to get the sandbags here. I've been talking to local people to find out how they weathered the storm. But first, just take a look at this. Keeping afloat, last night's storm claimed two boats in Newcastle's harbour sunk without a trace. Boat owners clambered aboard to keep from smashing against the harbour wall. Others watched helplessly from the shore. The night saw the lifeboat team out in force, not at sea but on land, rescuing people from their homes as waves shot over the roofs. At one point, NIE engineers had to be called in. An electricity distribution box had exploded, resulting in blue flashes, cracks, and a warning, water on the road might be live. All in all, this was a scene most people are more used to seeing on the big screen, not their doorstep. Sandbags did finally arrive, but it was well after midnight and the wind and waves had died down. NIE teams were still at the scene this morning after last night's electricity scare.
The water for a time was live until NIE power team came in and they switched everything else to dead, and we were able to go and search for more people and the houses as well.
The lifeboat men couldn't do anything, obviously there was no boats out, so they went down and piggybacked all the people out of their houses. Young boys, big boys, mummies and daddies and babies and all, so they helped them out well. They're good in the ground as well as in the sea.